Hey, today's topic is giants in your land. Giants in your land. And basically, we're going to talk about recognizing the giants in your land. And whenever I use the word land, I'm talking about your existence, your life, your body, your mind, your will, your emotions, your heart, your thoughts. The giants that I am referring to is those people, places, and things that are either strongholds or just oppressive things, depressive things, just toxic things, bullies, fears, anxieties, doubts, hopelessness. I mean, the list of giants can go on and on and on and on. Because the story in the Bible that I'm going to refer to is whenever the children of Israel had inherited Canaan land, and they came to the land, and the spies were sent in to scope out the land. The spies came back with a negative report. However, Joshua and Caleb, they had a positive report. The negative report was, there's giants in the land. We are like grasshoppers. We are like grasshoppers. So the giants in the land, in the promised land that was already promised to them, the land was, if it had been left up to all of the negative reports, the land would have been forfeited. It would have been forfeited because of what the eyes was perceiving, because of what the natural eye was perceiving. So whenever you are dealing with the giants in your land, those things that need to be pulled down, plucked up, pushed out, or whatever means needs to be stripped off of your land by any means necessary, you have to get it done. Now, the positive thing is if the Lord said it, if the Lord has promised it to you, the blessings of the Lord are yes and amen. Okay? Yes and amen. So if the Lord has actually given it to you, then provision has already been made since the foundations of the world. So, whenever you are talking about getting the giants out of your land, that means that I have to put forth an effort to do something to get this thing, get this mindset, get this discomfort, get this dis-ease out of my land, to get it out of my land. So that means that I'm going to have to go to the word of the Lord, see what the word of the Lord says about that thing. Say like if I'm struggling with hopelessness or doubt, I'm going to go to the scriptures and I'm going to like find the scriptures that talk about hopelessness and doubt, those scriptures that talk about hope and those scriptures that talk about faith. And that's what I'm going to begin to study. That's what I'm going to begin to feed myself. And that's what I'm going to, in return, begin to speak out of my mouth. Because faith cometh by hearing the word of God. Faith cometh by hearing the word of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? And then you have to like gain the faith, and then you begin to speak that stuff out and start calling those things that are not as though they were, as though they are. You have to start having the faith to believe that although I don't see it now, although I don't see it now, but I know that it's coming. Although I don't see it now, I know that it's already mine. So all I have to do is keep the faith, number one, and I have to continue to keep the faith, number two, and then all I have to continue to do is keep the faith. Number three, keep the faith. It's keeping the faith to believe, keeping the faith to believe, keeping the faith to believe in that word. Because if it's the word of the Lord, then it's not going to fail. It's not going to fail. It is there for you. It is there for you. Now, there are things that can cause us to forfeit that word, but it's only because of what we do, what we choose to do. And 9 times out of 10, that's just coming from disobedience in some kind of way. It's coming from disobedience in some kind of way. Because there's no force, there is no force created that is more powerful than the creative power of the Lord. No force can take away what the Lord has given to you. But we, like I said, in return, because of disobedience, can forfeit it. We can forfeit the promise. We can forfeit the promise because of disobedience, okay? So that's real important to know, y'all. That's real important to know. Because many times in this life, you know, we are people, they get angry at God. They get angry at Jehovah, Elohim, because something failed or something didn't manifest itself. They're like, oh, the Lord, you know, he promised this and it haven't come to pass. Or the Lord, you know, he said this and it hasn't come to pass. You know what? You got to either, like, number one, realize that everything is done in his timing. And then you have to realize also, number two, are you walking in some sort of disobedience? Are you the one that's forfeiting that promise? Are you the one that's forfeiting that promise? That's just like if you're signed on to like the pro NFL, the National Football League. Say like they sign you on because of your skills, because of what they, you know, what they believe in you. And you sign the contract. Now your promise from them is to like be on the team, you know, get that big fat check, you know, and just be on the team. But in return, are you like starting to eat anything that you want to eat? Are you starting to get out of shape? Are you starting to like get on drugs? You know, are you starting to do the things that's going against the obedience to that contract, and it's forfeiting your whole contract? Okay, because whenever they see that you can't run or catch that football and handle that football with skill like you used to could, and you falling into like a disobedience, you don't want to like follow the rules, you don't want to like go to the gym, you don't want to like do, I mean, with these contracts, a whole lot of stuff come with this stuff. It comes with this stuff whenever you want to like be in the NFL or anything. Anything where you sign a contract, even a job, if you go and you sign and you take the job, they expect you to do the job. That's the prerequisite. They expect you to do the job that you were hired to do. If you can't do that because of something that you're doing, you know, your lack of motivation, or you don't come to work on time, you know, you're falling into like disobedience to the program. So guess what? You can forfeit. You can forfeit, you know, the job tenure. You can forfeit the everything. You can forfeit your bonuses. You forfeit everything. So now to bring that back, bring it back to what I'm saying about the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord is true. The word of the Lord is true. And it's going to do what it set out to do. Now we, on the other hand, can forfeit that word from happening in our life. Just like Jesus died to save the world, you know, he died to atone our sin. And it says that if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Christ is risen from the dead, then you will be saved. You know, believe in your heart, confess with your mouth. But if you don't do these things and you're like, just free flowing and do what you want to do in life, you could care less about that scripture. You can care less. And guess what? Although Christ died to do this thing for you, you forfeit it. You forfeit it because you don't follow the contract. You don't follow what needs to be done in order to reap the reward from that word. Okay, so with the giants in the land, we're going to go back to the giants in the land. Whenever you see things in your land, whenever you see things in your house, whenever you see things that are working against what you know the word of the Lord says, you, if you are in tandem with that contract, you have the authority in Christ to pull that thing down, or pluck that thing up, or kick that thing out. You have the authority to do this thing, okay? You have the authority to tear down the giants in your land. You have the authority to tear down the giants in your land, but you have to exercise that authority. You have to exercise that authority. Tom, Dick, or Harry, or Susan, Sheila, or Sherry, they can't come in and authorize the giants to leave my land. Now, they can pray, and they can speak the word over me and hope that I get in line, but I am the one ultimately that's going to have to fall in line with the program. I am going to have to fall in line with the program in order to make the dream work. Okay? So yeah, just pay attention and start recognizing the giants, start recognizing the bullies, start recognizing the toxic habits, start recognizing the voices of the haters. And I'm not just talking about human haters. I'm talking about the demons whispering in your ears. I'm talking about your own self-talk, because you can talk your own self out of stuff. You know, I've done it. You can talk your own self out of stuff. So you have to be aware. You have to like scrutinize what comes into your head. You have to say, okay, where did that come from? You know, is that true? Even if you have to research it out to find out if it's true or not, you are the one who has been given the authority to manage your life here on this earth. You were put here for a reason and for a purpose. Do not let your life end. Do not let your life's journey end without doing what you have been put here to do. Don't waste your life. Don't waste it. And it don't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter how young you are. The message is, get the giants out of your land. Get the giants out of your land and finish well. Finish well. That's just like if you're a runner or sprinter and you happen to trip and fall, you're going to either like lay there and just say, man, I fell over that rock. Man, I fell over that rock or whatever. And then you're going to have to decide, am I going to get up? You know, because I feel embarrassed now. Am I going to get up, or am I going to like lay here and act like I'm hurt? You know, that's if you're really not. I mean, if you really hurt, then you might not be able to get up. You may need some recovery time. But if it's just a decision of you just getting up and start running again as fast as you can to try to win that race, to try to finish well, then that's what you need to do. That's what you need to do. You need to pick up and recover and finish well. So yeah, recognize the giants that's in your land. Recognize the giants that's in your land and look at those giants and say, how dare you oppose the word of the living God? Because I am more than a conqueror. I have the victory in Christ. I am healed, for by Jesus' stripes I am healed. For he was wounded for my transgressions and he was bruised for my iniquities. You know, I am a tree of righteousness, the planting of the Lord. You know, you have to say, if that giant is heaviness, you have to say, I put on the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. If it's like sadness or whatever, and you say the joy of the Lord is my strength. You know, you have to use the word of the Lord to tear down those giants. They're not going to fall any other way. They're not going to fall any other way. The only way these giants are going to fall is by hearing and being afflicted with the word of the Lord, with the word of the Lord. Okay? Because there is a scripture that says you submit to the Lord, you resist the devil and he will flee. So whenever you have these giants in your land, these things that are opposing the word of the Lord, that these things that are opposing standard, you have to like submit to the Lord. Now that's important, because a lot of people just say, you know, resist the devil and he'll flee. Now you forgot the first part. The first part is you have to submit to the Lord. Then you resist the devil and he will flee. So you submit to the authority of the Lord, and you use his authority. You go forth in the authority of Christ. You go forth in the authority of Christ. So yeah, I just wanted to jump on and give that encouraging word to just tear down the giants in your land. Tear them down. No longer allow them to roar and to bully you. No longer allow them to reign in your land. All right. So thank you for listening and thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. And until we meet again.